Cool.
Found it. Airports. We're in airports. We're in airports.
Other way you can meet people. Like I wasn't from New York, so I didn't have any, I didn't have friends, I didn't have anything. Just imagine like being on 31st and Broadway with no one to talk to, and you have to go out and make money by knowing people. Like, what do you do? So, the one thing I'd always done is go to the gym. And at the gym, I could find people who had a common interest with me, and then I would talk to them. And some of those people were then my first clients, or they knew somebody who was a client. And then I saw, okay, well, this works. So I'm not gonna try to like do any kind of marketing that other people do that works for them, because it's not gonna work for me. I'm not gonna try to fake it. I'm not gonna try to start doing all these networking events that are weird and I don't like big groups of people. But the gym thing works. So I'm gonna do that as much as possible.
Great to meet you.
Hey, Eleni, how are you?
Shadow Hamway, I'm a subscriber of the vlog. I'm actually so nervous right now. We started our career in real estate actually just on Monday.
Oh, nice.
And we're supposed to be at work right now. But
hi.
Oh, go to work. Hi, how are you?
She accompanied me because she knew that I was really excited.
Yeah. Awesome. Well, read the book. Let me know what you think.
Yeah, I'll take a picture, you guys.
Yeah.
How often do you meet with your team?
I mean, I'm with the team kind of all over the place every day, right? But I have a morning meeting every Monday. But the team's so large that I break it down where everyone meets with me once a month in that meeting.
Okay.
So I have four, right? So there's four groups of the team, and then I swap it out like every year.
Okay.
Yeah. The most important clients you'll ever have are the ones who are coming to you just for information. As salespeople, we're oftentimes not actually providing the product, right? We're providing an understanding of the information for which we then take a commission or a fee. We talked, you wished, we'd stop acting like it's nothing at all. In the first act, you're gone. But I wanted to do a sales guidebook for the people who work for me and who will continue to work for me. And then I did Sell It Like Serhant, the show on Bravo. And I saw that everything I know about selling, from selling real estate, I could apply to selling anything. And so I took all of that and everything I learned there about myself and about how I sell and put it into really a big playbook, and then fleshed it out with deal stories and made it funny, you know? We just got here to Dallas. Our flight from Chicago to Dallas last night was canceled because of rain, apparently. Lots of storms. Rebooked first thing this morning, Southwest Airlines, which we've never taken before, from Chicago Midway to Dallas Love Field, on standby, back of the plane. We're here waiting for our bags now, but we made it. We championed through. Never flown Southwest before. People really like Southwest, I hear, because there's no fees, which is great until you fly Southwest. And it is literally like, it just reminded me of going into the lunchroom in high school, because you get on the plane and everyone's staring at you and you're seeing all these middle seats and you're like, I don't know where to sit. And then you pass an empty seat and people look at you, you're like, you don't want to sit next to me. And I'm like, I don't know. It's like incredible social anxiety. It's that should be their new tagline. So I just went all the way to the back. No, I got an aisle somehow. I think because I sat next to a couple babies. and no one wanted to sit next to the babies. And I was like, listen, I'm totally fine with babies. I'll sit right next to them. Lesson learned, this guy. Lesson learned. Boom. That's how we do it.
We make Ryan play imagination games all day long, especially before he was about 10. It was a big thing for him to make up stories about the backseat person right there. Right?
Yeah.
He had to use things that you could observe and amplify that. He couldn't just make up some story.
Yeah.
He had to develop the story of that person. You know, the fact that she came in from Romania, she's just been picked up, and this is her new family. Look, she's trying to introduce herself to the people on the right. First time she's ever met them.
From Romania, that she is? Yeah, she's from Romania. Got it. Yeah. And every restaurant we would go into, every girl that would walk in, he would introduce her to me, which was a very terrifying experience.
Let's just say it worked.
I don't think it did. I'm not with any of those girls.
I know, but you're not uncomfortable walking up to a woman and saying hello.
Oh, gotcha. What else can we tell Hamway about Texas? It gets hot in the summer.
It's terribly hot, yeah.
And he would pump the AC so strong in the house that you'd get so cold. But if you complained about it, he'd say, you have to use your save-up muscle. I'm like, what the hell is your save-up muscle? It's like, it's the muscle you have to use to save up the cold. To use it when you're hot, when you're outside.
You gotta keep this because in about 3 minutes we're gonna be outside, you won't be able to breathe.
Yeah. And I never knew how to work that muscle. I got food too, don't worry. All right. Put that salesperson hat on, and they would focus so much on being a seller, right? And there's that phrase that says a watched pot never boils. Like, that's really important, because the worst thing that you can do when trying to make somebody a client or trying to make someone a customer is to actually try to make them a client or actually try to make them a customer, right? Selling is just dating. That's all it is. Like, how weird would it be if you walked into a bar, tapped on someone's shoulder and said, hey, do you need anything? Let me know if you need anything, I'm gonna be right over here. You laugh, because that would be weird, right? You don't put on your, I'm gonna meet a boyfriend or girlfriend hat when you walk into a bar, right? If anything, you dial that back. You try to stay relaxed, you try to stay cool, you try to stay yourself, because you know what you're really trying to do is create a relationship that hopefully will last longer than 20 seconds. So it was good. That's good. I never know what to expect here. Showing up to Dallas, 10 people could show up. I didn't expect nearly that many people. And it's awesome to hear from salespeople who are, see you, man. It's awesome to hear from salespeople in every different city and kind of what they're going through and what motivates them. And I love seeing that people have already read the book and read it twice already. The book came out 3 days ago. Like, that's insane. See ya. I'm making all these new friends. And people are leaving me little notes. People are giving me all these thank you notes. It's crazy. So I'm gonna go have dinner with family. You're gonna go and you're gonna shoot guns or something?
Yeah.
Yeah, great, you have fun. I'll see you at the airport tomorrow morning.